This is the scene I'm going to be doing a pen and ink of today. It's a street in Melbourne called Bridge Street, and it's a suburb of Richmond, and that tower building there is the Richmond Town Hall. I'm using Archer's cold press paper, which I find suits the type of pen and ink work that I like to do. So without any further ado, I'm going to start working on this. And I use, other than very lightly indicating where this tower is going to go, I don't do any prior drawing. I like the sort of the spontaneous nature of this type of work. Not trying to follow the scene exactly, really just trying to capture the feeling of the location. Now, so I start laying some ink down on the paper, and a towel here to take some moisture out of the brush that I'm using. And then while that's wet, I go in with my brush and just soften some of those edges. This tower is a key shape in this scene, so that's why I've started with it. Normally I would start from left to right, but in this case I started with the tower itself. Again, I'm not trying to throw in a lot of detail. I like to paint into the wet paint, and I like seeing the paint flow, similar to watercolor really. And after all, it is a water medium. Again, I'm not trying to be too accurate with my drawing, so I'm not too concerned if some of the shapes are a little bit out, but hopefully I'll end up capturing the feel for the scene. An area dries before I can soften some of the edges, then I'll just go over it again. One of the good things with using ink is that you can paint over it and you don't get the issues with back runs and that you get with watercolor. It's also a very good medium for teaching you how to draw and observe before you draw, because once you do put it down, then really you can't do very much to adjust it. Other than darkening it, you can't lighten it. It's a bit more of a challenge starting from this part of the painting, because you have to be careful that you don't drag the ink over your page. I think you notice is this will dry much lighter than what it looks when it's wet. Throw a couple of figures in here. Okay. Sometimes you can use the brush like this to leave some texture on the paper that makes it seem a lot more interesting. That will do for this part of the street. We'll come back to it later. Now there's some soft hills in the distance, so I'll just put them in the brush. I don't really want a sharp line in the distance here, so I'm not using the pen to put that in. I really want some shapes that might look like spires and things like that. There we go. Now I want that to dry a little bit before I put in all this other area down here. And dried enough. Just use that to tone that bottom section. Okay, so I've just dried this with the dryer to speed things along a little bit. And now I'm going to go back and some of these shapes that I see down here, and they're going to be softening off as I move into the distance. And it'll make sure things get lighter and softer as they move further away. Throw another level here. Okay. Shadow. Right, this side is done for now. Now I'm going to work on this section here, put some lampposts in. Just going to draw in with the pen here some of the shapes, especially the distant shapes. Paint over these lines. It's going to get cropped to a particular size, but time being I'll just paint through them. That'll do. I think I'll turn all this down too. And we'll do this road. Just pre-wet this area here. So we'll put this over the light to come through. I'll paint through with this ink. Just straight on dry paper. Leave a few little untouched areas, that's fine. I'll just add a little bit of sparkle. Here we go. Now, while that's wet, I might just lift some of this colour. Okay. just to put some lines and variety on this roadway. Okay. And there's trams that run along this as well, so. A lot of lines there. Too much light, but I do want a bit of a lit area there. Texture. Make it a bit stronger down here. Again, remember this will dry quite a bit lighter. Right, I'll just dry that now. All right, so that's dry, and I'll now continue to work on this side of it for my scene. And some lampposts. put in this big pole here. Just mark it off now, come back to it in the dry spit. We'll just dry that now. Drawing a couple of figures here. I'll put their shadow in later once that's all done. Figure in here. There you go. Darken this. Just darken this wall here a bit. I don't want to too dark on this one, just add a bit more water to that mixture. Darkness. All right, now this is just about done here. I have to put some shadows on the roadway and the footpath, and we have to put some of these lines in the sky. I might do first. So, put these lampposts on this side too, just to not too need it. Now this road is up, we're up a hill, up on a hill here, and then it drops down, and then this is the distant road here, so all these buildings drop down quite sharply. This is a key point connection for all these cables. These overhead cables are mainly for tram lines and that. And I don't want that point to be directly over this tower, so I'm going to just put a little mark there, and then from that point, grab some ink. I'm going to run the cables out. Let me connect up to another lamppost, which I should put in here. These wires go everywhere, so. Doesn't really matter. Some supports for these awnings. Just darken underneath some awnings. There we go. Now, some more of these tram lines in. In the distance, maybe some trams, so not quite some marks there. If I want a little bit of ink, I'll dip my brush into the nib. That allows me to pick up a bit of ink that way. Really, I'm just throwing some birds flying around the tower. Just to add some more interest. Now, some strong shadow underneath these cars. This shadow is stronger under the cars rather than the side of them, so I'll just paint that in first. Brush with the pen, sorry. Quite strong. Actually cuts through the paper and marks. Out the side of these cars. onto the front. Some light's coming from over here in the scene. Now it's a bit confusing because it's so bright in the photograph. Yeah. Many things to make sure all these shadows follow in the right same direction. Sign dull. I don't want that to be too bright. Because really, this is the focal point here. Get a brush with very little ink in it. Just dry that. That will all get cropped off later anyway. Just gonna add a bit of a texture for this window pane. Don't try to make these letters too perfect. Now I've had a look at this and I'm going to strengthen some of these lines. Just make it stronger there.